Quaker.
President, please be seated.
Le président, veuillez vous asseoir.
The court
is now back in session.
L'audience est reprise.
Before we hand over the floor to the prosecution,
avant de redonner la parole,
the chairman would like to inquire with the prosecution.
À l'accusation, j'aimerais me tourner vers le banc de l'accusation.
How much time you need in your remaining response?
De temps avez-vous besoin pour pouvoir finir votre réponse?
Yes. Good morning, Mr. President.
Bonjour, Monsieur le Président.
I have five annexes to cover.
Je dois couvrir cinq annexes.
A couple of them I will have to spend a lot more time on than the others.
So
my best estimate this time is I would use the rest of the morning and some of the afternoon. I'll give the trial chamber an update as to where I am when we finish at lunch.
But
if I had to estimate now, I would probably say the rest of the time this morning and between a half an hour and an hour after lunch.
Besoin d'une demi-heure ou une heure après la pause déjeuner.
President, thank you very much.
And you may proceed. Je vous remercie. Vous pouvez maintenant poursuivre.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Monsieur Lissac, merci, Monsieur le Président.
I have the five remaining annexes
je vais
to address. And as I indicated, some of them will require a little
comme
more time than others based on either the nature of the documents or the number of objections that have been made. The first annex that I will address this morning is Annex 6, which is our submitted collection of DK biographies. There are three different types of biographies that are included in this annex, and I will deal with each of those types separately and endeavor to respond to the various objections that have been raised by counsel for the accused in relation to each of those categories of documents. The first category of biographies that I will address are biographies that were prepared by S21 prisoners. And this type of biography is quite easy to identify in our annex because we have, as best as we could, endeavored to indicate in the description column whether the biography pertained to someone had been arrested. But in addition to that, the biographies are quite easily identified because they are only one page in length, while the other two types of biographies that I will address later are substantially longer. And I'd like to start by first demonstrating what these types of biographies look like by putting on the screen one example, if I may have permission to do so, Mr.
Avec
President.
La permission de la chambre, Monsieur le Président.
President,
le
yes,
Président.
You may proceed.
Vous pouvez poursuivre.
Thank you.
The
biography I'd like to put up on the screen right now
is,
I think it's the other one. The example I wanted to put on the screen now is document D2-15.33, which is the S21 biography of a female prisoner, Chok Yan. Now, I note that this is one of a group of documents that the Kyusam Pan defense objected to on the grounds that they could not determine where the document came from, and thus there was no basis to admit it. In fact, there is extensive information in the case file about these S21 biographies of prisoners, biographies that typically included a photograph, as you will see in the example on the screen.
graphie, comme vous pouvez
and
le voir d'ailleurs.
For anyone who's ever visited Tool Slang, these photographs will be hauntingly familiar. In terms of where they came from, I would also note that the biographies include handwritten identification letters and numbers from DC CAM in the upper right-hand corner, which also give us information as to who and how the document was collected. And this applies to all four of a group of S21 biographies that were objected to by the QSUM 10 defense on the same basis. Now, the prima facie authenticity of these S21 biographies is confirmed by the format of the documents itself. Most are a standard one-page typed form in which the responsible S21 cadre would handwrite the personal biographical and background information when prisoners would first arrive at S21. And after that, biographical information had been written down, the prisoner would then be photographed and the photo attached to the form. And you can see that in the example that we just showed. Let me show a second example, which is document D2-15.37, which is the S21 biography of New Sylvain. And you'll see that the format of this biography is identical to the one we previously saw.
And
this consistent format itself is something that gives us an indicia of reliability. But we also know how these documents were prepared from the testimony of OCP proposed witness TCW/698. This person was the S21 cadre who was responsible for documenting the entry of prisoners into S21 and maintaining prisoner lists. And in his OCIJ interview, which is case file document D22/9, this witness explained the procedure by which he completed these biographies upon the arrival of each prisoner at S21. And that leads me to a second objection that has been made regarding this category of documents by the Nunchea team,
a
unsupported and unsubstantiated assertion that all biographies submitted by our office were made under torture and thus should be excluded. In response to that, I would first note that only the first category of biographies that I am addressing are biographies that came from prisoners. That is not the case with the second two categories. And second, as is made clear from the testimony of TCW 698, these one-page biographies were prepared when the prisoners first arrived at S21, well before they were sent for interrogation and subjected to torture. Indeed, even before they were assigned a prison cell. TCW 698 has also testified that in completing these forms, he did not question the prisoners about matters such as the conduct they were accused of, potential moral offenses, those types of issues. And we can see from these forms itself that the information obtained from the prisoners was very basic personal background information identifying the individual, such as their name, their age, sex, place of birth, address, position, and identity of their parents, spouses, and children. The forms also indicate the date and place of arrest, which of course is information that also would be known by the security cadres who had conducted their arrest and were responsible for them being brought to S21. My point here is that the assertion that these biographies were obtained by torture is not only inconsistent with the evidence in the case file that was provided by TCW-698, but also the nature of this information itself is not the type of information one would reasonably expect that torture would be needed to obtain. These are fairly straightforward biographical background forms. And I would also note that our proposed use of these S21 biographies is a fairly limited one, and one that would not violate the torture convention in any event, which is simply to use these documents to identify the persons who were arrested and subject to detention at S21. And I will address the issues regarding S21 confessions and the torture convention a little more in one of my later annexes. But at the time, in terms of the relevancy of these S21 biographies in the current case, case 002/01, this information remains relevant in this case because both the S21 biographies and S21 prisoner lists, which is the next annex I will discuss, they are both key sources of evidence that help establish the structure of the democratic Kampuchea regime, both how it was organized in terms of ministries, districts, offices, and the identity of who was who in the regime. So, for example, the S21 biographies that are on Annex 6 include cadres from ministries such as the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, the Ministry of Social Affairs, including a number of hospitals, the Ministry of Commerce, as well as cadres from various K offices. These were offices that formed Office 870.
Qui constituait le bureau
an issue that
870,
is part of the upcoming administrative structure segment of this
du segment
trial.
Du procès relatif aux structures administratives.
There are also biographies from cadres from regional organizations such as the East Zone, Sector 105,
comme
which was
la zone
the military
est,
area,
105 dans la
and biographies of cadres
des
military divisions.
De cadres des divisions militaires.
So these documents are one of the
donc,
sources that help us put together the complete picture
à dresser un tableau de la situation et de la façon dont était structuré le régime du Cambodge démocratique et des fonctions qu'occupaient les uns et les autres.
And I would add here, as there's been a specific objection to documents from the Ministry of Social
Affairs,
and certainly with Ying Tirit now severed from
dès
this
lors
case,
que Ying Tirit n'est plus visé par ce
these documents
dossier,
have a different
après la
significance now,
ces documents ont
but
une
they remain
importance
relevant
différente,
for that
certes,
same purpose,
mais ils restent
and a limited purpose,
dans le cadre
to show
de cet objectif même. C'est un objectif limité, mais qui reste inchangé.
Was
il s'agit de montrer quelle était la structure
one of which
du régime, y compris la structure des ministères, y compris le ministère des Affaires sociales.
I'm now going to move on to the other two
présent,
categories
aux deux
of biographies,
de biographies
whose content is a little more substantive and of more import, I think, to the issues before this chamber.
Et plus encore,
but before I do so,
légal aux questions traitées.
I have to briefly address
avant
one of the objections
faire,
that was made
revenir sur des objections
by the Ying Sari
soulevées
defense.
Par la défense de Ying Sari.
Who questioned the professional
celle-ci
ethics
a mis en cause
of our office,
professionnelle de notre bureau,
asserting that we were trying to
en
sneak
prétendant
in
que nous essayions de faire passer subrepticement des déclarations de témoins en les faisant passer
and
pour
demanding
des
biographies.
La défense
as to why
demander des explications
had been listed
sur les raisons pour lesquelles ces documents avaient été présentés comme des biographies.
And the first example that was cited by
le premier exemple cité par Maître Carnavas
– The first example was to support this assertion that we were trying to sneak in witness statements as biographies, was IS 19.46, which is the biography of an individual known as
Heng Phaly.
But if you look at the OCP's Annex 6 of biographies, which is document
E109/4.6,
this document is number 6
que ce document porte in that annex. Le numéro 6 dans cette annexe.
And when you look at our annex,
lorsque
you will see very clearly that what we have identified as the biography
is a single page
from this document.
C'est une seule page du dit document.
A single page, Khmer
ERN 00051643.
English ERN 00337756 and French ERN 00593511.
337756 et en français 00593511. Il s'agit de la biographie de cette personne
now
qui est contenue en une seule page.
For this person,
et il y a une déclaration de témoin correspondant à cette
personne file document
qui
IS
fait également partie du document IS 19.46. Cette déclaration de témoin a été énumérée séparément par nous dans notre annexe 12, à savoir l'annexe relative aux déclarations de témoin.
Document
c'est le document
E109.4.12. And if you look at Annex 12, document number 263 in that annex is the interview of Heng Phaly that was conducted by DC-CAM. This exact same scenario applies
le même
for the second example
s'applique au deuxième
that Mr. Carnovas
exemple
gave
qui a été cité par Maître Carnavas
was purportedly
dans l'intention de montrer que notre bureau tentait de faire passer subrepticement les déclarations de témoins en les présentant comme des biographies. Il a cité l'exemple
IS 19.157. And again, if you look at our annex
à nouveau,
6
penchez-vous sur
of
notre
biographies,
6 concernant les biographies,
you will find identified as document
vous allez
number 27
voir
the
le
pages
27
from that document
et
that
les
correspond
pages de ce document
to the biography of this individual,
à la biographie de cette personne,
a person named Ru M.
Un certain Ru M.
And once again,
et à nouveau,
the witness statement
la déclaration de témoin correspondant à cette personne est identifiée séparément dans notre annexe de déclaration de témoin, soit l'annexe 12, c'est le document 963. Le troisième et dernier exemple cité par la défense de l'Ansari,
IS 3.5,
ne concerne pas de déclaration de
témoin.
C'est la biographie d'une personne qui est suivie par une série de photos de la prisonnière et de son mari.
So I bring this up because it is troublesome to us that the Ing Sari defense would accuse our office
que la défense de l'Ing Sari accuse notre bureau d'avoir violé les règles d'éthique professionnelle en citant à l'appui des exemples
unfounded
qui, on le voit bien, ne sont pas fondés.
It is quite clear
de toute évidence,
si had made an effort
si la défense
to read
avait
our document annexes
lu
before making
nos documents et nos annexes
accusations,
avant de se lancer dans des accusations à considérer,
that we had separately
elle aurait bien vu que nous avions identifié séparément les biographies
and witness statements
de l'annexe 6
12.
Et les déclarations de témoins à l'annexe 12. Je ne vais pas insister davantage là-dessus.
Other than to say,
je me contenterai de dire
that our office
que
takes its professional
bureau
responsibilities
prend
extremely
très au sérieux sa responsabilité professionnelle.
Both our responsibilities to the victims
notre responsabilité
of this
envers les victimes dans ce pays, ainsi
to ensure
que
that the
notre obligation de veiller
followed,
à ce que le
and
droit
that the legitimate
prévale
rights of the accused
et à ce
are
que
respected.
Les droits légitimes des accusés soient respectés.
And I understand that defense will take issue with
je
positions
que la défense
of ours,
contestera
that we are
notre
here
position,
to have a trial on facts and law,
comme quoi nous sommes là pour avoir un procès fondé sur les faits et le droit. Je sais que la défense va nous mettre en cause avec énergie,
but I hope that in the future,
mais à l'avenir,
we will stick to legitimate advocacy
j'espère
and avoid
qu'on en
this type of
s'en tiendra à des arguments légitimes et qu'on évitera de lancer des accusations gratuites
ethics.
Et non fondées concernant notre déontologie.
That said, I would like now to
là-dessus,
move on to
je vais passer
the second category
à la deuxième catégorie
of biographies
de
biographies that are included in Annex 6.
Figurant à l'annexe 6.
And these are what are titled as revolutionary
le titre
biographies.
Est le suivant,
and
biographies révolutionnaires.
Annex 6 includes
l'annexe
a number of biographies,
revolutionary
biographies
révolutionnaires
of cadres from various ministries, zones, and other DK organizations, including three revolutionary biographies of cadres from
Sector 105,
which are documents numbers 10, 26, and 39
26 et 39
on Annex 6.
That's
documents 10, 26, and 39.
Je répète, documents 10, 26 et
there
39.
Are examples of these forms. For cadres from
il y a des formulaires correspondant à des cadres du ministère du Commerce et des Affaires sociales.
Those are documents,
ce sont
28
les documents
and 35
28
on Annex 6.
Et 35 de l'annexe 6.
And there is also a revolutionary biographie
il y a aussi une biographie révolutionnaire d'un messager qui travaillait à S21,
document 27
c'est le document
27 on the annex.
De l'annexe.
And to be very clear, these documents are not
pour
biographies that were prepared
ce ne sont pas
when cadres
des biographies
were
arrested. Par
they
des
are
qui ont été arrêtés.
A, what is clearly a standard form
il s'agit d'un
that
formulaire
cadres
standard
were required to complete.
Que devaient remplir les cadres.
And we would submit one of the principal
selon
means
nous,
by which the Communist
des
Party
moyens
of Kampuchea
par le PCK
monitored the class
contrôlait
backgrounds and
l'origine
of persons
et les connexions
to ascertain
des
whether they were loyal
pour déterminer
to the party
fidèles à la cause du parti,
or whether they had
ou
background issues
s'il y avait des problèmes d'origine de classe qui les rendaient suspects.
These documents are relevant
et précisément
to case
ce type de documents. Ces documents sont pertinents dans
not
le cadre de ces 002/1, non seulement dans le cadre des preuves générales permettant d'établir la manière dont le régime du Kampuchea démocratique fonctionnait,
but also because biographies were one of the means by which former officials
par lesquels
and soldiers of the Law and Order regime
du régime
and
Lannol,
their relatives and contacts
que leur
were identified.
Et leurs contacts étaient
this
repérés.
Is a key issue in this case
dans le présent
for
dossier,
reasons
c'est là une
I will
question
discuss
fondamentale,
in more detail
pour des raisons sur lesquelles je vais m'étendre plus en détail dans le cadre de l'examen de l'annexe suivante.
Now, in regards to the authenticity
concernant
of this category
de cette catégorie de biographie,
the Kyusampan defense
la défense
has objected
de Kyusampan
to some of these documents,
a contesté certains de ces
in particular the
en
three biographies from Sector 105 cadres,
de cadre du secteur 105,
asserting that
soutenant
the testimony of a witness
le témoignage
who had testified regarding these biographies,
personne concernant ces biographies,
TCW
à savoir
457,
TCW 457.
The Kyusampan team asserts that the testimony of that witness is insufficient because he merely
n'était pas
identified
suffisant,
who
au motif
the people
que le
were,
témoin n'avait
and thus
fait
the reliability,
que dire où se trouvaient certaines personnes,
of these documents
et a donc
is still in
mis
question.
En cause la fiabilité de ces documents.
First, I would dispute counsel's characterization of that testimony.
Je ne puis souscrire à cette description faite par la défense de ce témoignage. Le témoin 457 a fait davantage que d'identifier les personnes qui ont rédigé les biographies. Ce témoin a confirmé l'exactitude d'informations importantes contenues dans les biographies, y compris les noms et pseudonymes et les conjoints et les fonctions exercées par les personnes qui ont rédigé la biographie.
For the record, the case file number of the statement
la
of this witness
des déclarations de
is
ce témoin est la suivante.
D125/138. But in addition to the testimony of this witness,
en plus
which corroborates
de la déposition de ce
the authenticity
qui vient étayer l'authenticité de ces documents.
And I would remind the chamber that the prima facie standards for admissibility
les normes
have already
de recevabilité
been laid out.
À première vue
and there
ont
is
déjà
absolutely
été
no indication
énoncées,
here
et ici,
that these biographies
rien
are forgeries.
Ne laisse penser que ces
to
biographies
the contrary,
pourraient être des faux. Que du contraire.
It is quite interesting to put all these biographies
il est très intéressant
together
de
and see that they have
confronter
a
ces différentes biographies.
And structure.
On peut constater que leur structure et leur format sont similaires.
All the organizations.
Ceci vaut pour toutes les organisations.
And I will get into that in a little more detail.
Je vais y revenir de façon plus détaillée dans quelques instants.
But suffice it to say that there
je
is a common format
de dire que l'on retrouve
to
un format
these revolutionary
commun
biographies
à toutes ces biographies
and virtually identical questions in each of them. Whether
il s'agit
a form
pratiquement
that came
des
from
mêmes questions,
105,
qu'il s'agisse
a form
de cadres
that came from the Ministry of Commerce,
du secteur 105,
or a form
qu'il s'agisse
came,
de formulaires du ministère du Commerce ou encore
S21.
De cadres travaillant
and that tells
à S21. Ceci nous permet
when
de tirer des conclusions.
A similar form
lorsqu'on constate
used
l'existence
different
d'un format similaire qui est utilisé dans différentes
country,
organisations, dans différentes parties
clear
du pays,
that this form was the
cela
result
montre
of a
clairement
centralized
que
effort
ce formulaire est le produit d'une action centralisée visant à contrôler l'origine des cadres du Kampuchea démocratique.
What specifically am I referring to?
À quoi est-ce que je fais référence
précisément?
Chacune de ces biographies révolutionnaires
the identical structure in,
présente
first of all, in terms
une structure
of sections.
Identique, en particulier concernant les différentes sections.
Of questions.
Tout d'abord, il y a
usually,
une série de questions.
Up to 16 questions.
En général, il y a jusqu'à 16 questions
to the person, the cadre
qui
who's
portent
filling the form.
Sur le cadre en question, lequel remplit ce formulaire.
Applicable to that cadre.
On y trouve des données
there is a
personnelles.
Second section
ensuite vient une deuxième
of questions
section
about their spouse,
composée de questions relatives aux conjoints.
Which is not as many questions, up
il y a
to about
moins
10 questions.
De questions, une dizaine environ.
There is a third section
il y a ensuite une troisième section
asking questions
où
about
les questions
their children.
Portent sur les enfants de la personne.
A fourth section
ensuite vient une quatrième section avec
their biological
des
parents.
Questions sur les parents biologiques de la
a
personne.
Fifth section
vient ensuite une cinquième section
with questions about
avec
parents
des questions
in law.
Sur la belle-famille, les
a
beaux-parents.
Sixth section
une sixième section ensuite
questions about biological
avec
siblings.
Des questions sur les frères et
and
sœurs
finally,
biologiques et enfin une dernière section
which is typically titled
qui en général est intitulée amis proches et cercle de relations,
the revolutionary
relations
organization.
Hors de l'organisation révolutionnaire.
And the questions in each of these sections
dans chacune de ces sections
are almost always the
les
same.
Questions sont presque toujours identiques.
In that last section,
dans cette
one
dernière
of the things that's
section,
striking is that
ce qui est frappant,
the first
notamment,
question
c'est que la première
is
question
one, how many close
concerne
friends
le
do
nombre
you have?
D'amis proches qu'a la
and
personne.
And I must tell the chamber that
je dois dire
each
à la chambre
que dans chacune at,
des biographies que j'ai examinées, la réponse
none.
Est toujours la même, à savoir aucun.
Now I will go through a few of these questions.
Je vais passer en revue certaines de ces questions.
But I turn now to explain briefly the
je voudrais brièvement
relevance
donner des explications
of these,
quant à la pertinence
category,
de
cette
catégorie de
biographies,
à savoir les biographies révolutionnaires.
And the relevance we would submit
selon nous,
with these documents is as much
leur pertinence
in the questions that
est liée
are being asked. And maybe more so in the questions
aux questions
that are asked
qui y sont posées
than are in the answers.
Davantage qu'aux
because
réponses
the
qui sont
questions
données.
That are part
en effet,
of the standard form
les questions qui font partie
show
du formulaire standard
how the party
montrent la façon dont
members,
le parti contrôlait ses membres
and more specifically how they
et plus précisément la façon dont le parti
suspect
repérait
because of their class
les suspects compte tenu de leur origine de classe, compte tenu de leur famille ou des éventuels liens qu'ils pourraient avoir avec certaines personnes,
who may have connections to the Lon Nol regime.
Y compris des personnes pouvant avoir des liens avec le régime de Lon Nol.
The biography forms include
Les
as standard
formulaires
questions,
comportent des questions
the
standards,
occupation
à savoir
and class
portant sur
before joining the revolution.
L'emploi occupé par ces personnes avant d'entrer dans les rangs de la Révolution.
A question that obviously,
Il y a une question
if truthfully answered,
qui
would require people to identify any,
amenait les gens
positions prior
à
to the
indiquer
Democratic
quels emplois ils occupaient
that
avant
made them part,
l'existence du régime du Kampuchea démocratique. Et si les gens répondaient honnêtement, ils risquaient de se dénoncer en tant qu'ennemis ou en tant que personnes ayant été associées au régime de Lon Nol.
There is a series of questions in each of these biographies.
Dans chacune de ces biographies,
that ask,
il y a une série de questions
when they joined the
portant
revolution,
sur le moment auquel la personne est entrée dans les rangs de la Révolution, portant sur la personne
joining,
qui les a fait adhérer, portant sur les raisons pour lesquelles les gens ont adhéré. Des questions sont posées sur le moment où ils sont entrés dans la Révolution, dans la Ligue des Jeunes et dans les organisations du parti. Il s'agissait là d'étapes différentes par lesquelles devait passer une personne afin de devenir membre du PCK.
They ask what their education was in the old regime.
Quel a été le parcours scolaire de la personne en question sous l'ancien régime?
How often
une question porte sur la fréquence à laquelle la personne
been examined.
A vu examiner
and as a result, there is
sa biographie révolutionnaire
forms
et a fait
about
une autocritique
process,
et on a donc des informations sur l'autocritique, une autre question qui relève du segment à venir.
And I would also direct the chamber some of the questions relating to relationships with spouses and children are also very telling.
Les conjoints et les enfants, cela est très
there is a question
parlant.
In each of these forms
dans chacun de ces formulaires,
that asks in relation to the individual spouse
concernant le conjoint,
quote, in human nature,
je cite,
how does he or she love, hate, and affiliate him
comment
or herself with you as
qu'il
husband or
vous
wife.
Aime, quelles sont ses relations
and
avec vous sur le plan humain en tant que mari et femme.
How much
il y a aussi une question
does the spouse have a political,
sur
economical, or sentimental influence
l'influence
and
politique,
power
économique
on you.
Et
and
sentimentale
again, both
du
the
conjoint.
Questions and the answers that you will see
tant les questions que les réponses
are quite telling as to,
nous en disent
the expectations
beaucoup
of the Communist
sur
Party
les attentes
of Kampuchea
du PCK
for people who were part of its organization
envers
and
ses
the expectation that there would be no other
organizations.
Loyalties.
On exigeait des gens qu'ils ne soient loyaux à personne d'autre.
Your Honors, I'll now go to the third
j'en viens à la
and last category
troisième
of
et dernière catégorie de biographies
that are included in Annex 6,
figurant à l'annexe 6,
which are three biographies that were written
là, trois biographies
by cadres
rédigées
from the Ministry
par
of Foreign Affairs,
au ministère des Affaires étrangères,
all apparently around the same time, December 1976.
Période, à savoir décembre 1976.
You will find these documents in Annex 6
ces documents se
as documents
6,
number 12,
ce sont les documents
37,
12,
and 40.
37 et 40.
And they are not forms like the
ce
revolutionary biography documents
comme
that
les
I just discussed,
biographies révolutionnaires
but these
dont
are lengthier documents
il s'agit de documents
written in a narrative
plus longs,
style,
qui sont rédigés dans un style narratif
a detailed history,
et qui retracent de façon détaillée le parcours de la personne.
The trial chamber has, in fact, previously seen a one such document,
déjà
which was the biography written
un document
by
de ce
Long
type, à savoir
Nguyen.
La biographie rédigée par Long
the
Nguyen.
The number of that document, which is before the chamber, is E3/128.
Il s'agit du document E3/128.
And the chamber will recall that Ingsri requested
la chambre se souviendra
Long Nguyen to write que this biography after inquiring
Yang
whether he was CIA.
A demandé à Long Norin de
rédiger
cette biographie après avoir essayé de déterminer s'il était membre de la CIA. Les trois biographies faisant partie de l'annexe 6 sont très analogues à celles rédigées par Long Norin.
One of the cadres, Ministry of Foreign Affairs.
L'un des cadres du ministère des Affaires étrangères
est un témoin
qui est prévu de faire citer à comparaître devant la Chambre. C'est TCW 724.
His testimony in his OCIJ statement
dans le cadre de son audition avec les juges d'instruction,
ce témoin
a fait un récit très similaire à celui de Long Norin.
That led him
quant aux
to write the biography.
Circonstances l'ayant conduit à rédiger son autobiographie.
In his statement,
dans
which is case
sa
file,
déclaration, et ici je vous donne la référence, document D-199-20, TCW-724
testified as follows.
A dit ce qui suit.
Quote,
je cite.
Question. Why were you asked to write
pourquoi
your
vous a-t-on demandé de rédiger votre autobiographie?
Answer,
réponse.
I was accused
parce
of being
qu'on
a KGB
accusé
and CIA
membre
agent.
D'être agent du
One
KGB et de la CIA.
One's past
il fallait
by revealing
justifier
it.
Son passé en
question,
le divulguant.
Who asked you
question.
To write your
qui vous a demandé de rédiger votre autobiographie?
Answer,
réponse.
Ying Sari himself.
Ying Sari en personne.
I believe he received the order
je pense
from above,
qu'il en a reçu l'ordre d'en haut, mais je n'en suis pas certain.
The autobiography was written
l'autobiographie
in December
a été rédigée
1976,
en décembre 1976,
so it came as a result of accusations.
C'était donc le résultat de certaines
question,
accusations. Question.
Did you have to answer specific prepared
avez-vous
questions?
Dû
answer, yes,
répondre à des
and I also
questions
had to talk
spécifiques
about
préparées.
The things
réponse,
I had
oui,
done
j'ai
in the
aussi
past.
Dû parler de ce que j'avais fait dans le passé.
Ying Sari had suggested
Sari
I should do this well,
avait dit que je devais bien
words,
le faire, autrement dit, que je devais remplir correctement le formulaire.
By this, he meant that my answers
il voulait dire par là que mes réponses
the of the
devaient être conformes à l'esprit
I
des questions.
Wrote that my
c'est pourquoi j'ai écrit que mon grand-père, qui était premier ministre dans trois gouvernements, était un traître.
The Khmer Rouge were fond of this sort of thing.
Les Khmer Rouges aimaient ce genre de choses.
Question.
Question.
Your first wife was French.
Votre première femme était française.
And I'll omit the name reference.
Je ne vais
was
pas
that
citer
a problem?
Le nom. Est-ce que c'était un problème?
Answer.
Réponse.
The Khmer Rouge were somewhat suspicious.
Les Khmer Rouges
but I was
étaient
never directly asked,
soupçonneux,
taken to
mais
task
on ne m'a
by the Khmer
jamais
Rouge because
critiqué
my wife was
du fait que ma femme était française.
Question. Who were the autobiographies
question.
Intended for?
Quel était l'objectif
answer.
De ces autobiographies? Réponse. J'ai
you would need to ask
à qui était destinée l'autobiographie
to somebody.
Réponse.
I do
je l'ai remise
know.
À Ying Sari. Je ne sais pas s'il l'a communiqué à quelqu'un d'autre. Je n'en sais rien.
Now, Your Honors, this testimony itself is more than sufficient
ce témoignage
to confirm
suffit
the
largement
authenticity
pour confirmer l'authenticité
of the biography. Which I note
de la
is document,
biographie en question,
case file document,
à savoir
D
le document
D-366/7.1.831. That's D-366.
Je répète, D-366/7.1.831.
And combined with the testimony of Long
en conjonction avec la déposition de Long Norin et
him,
avec sa
this
biographie,
ceci
suffit largement
from Ministry of Foreign Affairs
à confirmer
are
que
not
les
forgeries.
Biographies du ministère des Affaires étrangères
and
ne
I would
sont
add
pas
to
des
that,
faux. J'ajouterai
that
une chose.
Consistent with the testimony
ceci cadre
that I just
avec
read from
le témoignage
TCW
du témoin TCW 724 dont je viens donner lecture. La première page de sa biographie comporte la description suivante de son grand-père.
Quote,
je cite.
My grandfather's name,
le nom de mon grand-père,
which I will omit
et
now,
ici je ne vais pas le citer,
feudal class and reactionary
féodale, traître réactionnaire
serving the French
au service
colonists.
Des colonialistes français.
This corroboration further
ceci
demonstrates the authenticity
vient corroborer
et
prouver
of this document,
l'authenticité et la fiabilité de ce document comme cela a été confirmé par TCW 724.
Now these documents are relevant
ces documents
in this case,
sont pertinents dans le cadre de la présente
ways.
Affaire et ce à mains égards. Premièrement,
the biographies of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs cadres,
des cadres du ministère des Affaires étrangères,
including the mere fact that they were requested
le fait même
to write
que
these
ces cadres devaient rédiger ce genre de documents,
Ying Siri's role in security matters,
met en évidence le rôle de Ying Siri
pour
les questions de sécurité.
Reflects,
et cela
the political education
également
of cadres.
L'éducation politique
the political
des
education of cadres is an issue that is
cette
part of the upcoming segment
politique des cadres relève du prochain segment de ce projet.
The segment that will follow that relates to
le
military
suivant
issues
concernera
and
les questions militaires ainsi que le rôle de chacun des accusés concernant
issues.
Les questions militaires et de sécurité.
So these are part of the foundational issues that my colleague
ceci
discussed yesterday.
Des éléments de fondement dont mes confrères ont parlé hier.
Are going to provide the foundation
il s'agit là de jeter le fondement
future trials
des
or possibly additional crimes that may be added in
ou éventuellement de l'ajout d'autres crimes.
And a few examples of how
je vais citer quelques exemples illustrant la manière dont ces biographies sont pertinentes par rapport à ces questions.
Starting by going right back to
je
the biography of
TCW 724,
who again testified that
cette
he wrote this
a
after being accused
avoir écrit sa biographie après avoir été accusé d'être agent du KGB ou de la CIA.
And again, this document, which is
D366/7.1.831,
contains the
ce
following statement at the very outset of
la
the biography.
Suivante, quote, qui intervient dès le début de la biographie. Je cite,
our comrade in charge
notre
has reported
camarade responsable
that our class enemy
a signalé
has
que notre ennemi de classe
me.
Avait lancé des accusations
I would
contre
like
moi.
To sincerely
je voudrais sincèrement
present my autobiography
et
to the party
honnêtement
as
présenter ma biographie au parti, comme suit.
So, from the very start of this document,
fin de citation.
It evidences
donc, dès le début du document, l'on voit quel était le rôle de Ying Sari pour les questions de sécurité ainsi que ses responsabilités concernant le contrôle des cadres de son organisation. L'une des deux autres biographies de cadres du ministère des Affaires étrangères, c'est le document D366/7.1.829.
And I do not believe this witness has been
je ne pense pas
individual has been listed as a
que
witness
cette
by
personne
any party,
ait été
but
cité
he is a
en
person,
tant que témoin par
even
une quelconque
he has
des
not
parties,
been listed, he is a person
mais
that
néanmoins,
at some
il s'agit d'une personne que la Chambre
hearing.
Souhaitera peut-être
so I will refrain
entendre
from
à un moment ou un autre. Je ne vais donc pas
time.
Citer son nom
but
pour
he
l'instant.
At least as of
c'est une personne
November 2009, was still alive,
qui, en
at
tout
which
cas, en novembre 2009, était encore en vie. C'est la date à laquelle il a fait
judges,
une déclaration devant le bureau des juges d'instruction. Il s'agit du document D233/11.
And his biography, this is a one of the intellectuals who studied in France and joined the front after the March 1970 coup. And he describes in his biography how Ying Siri, who is referred to as buying special envoy representing Ankar, educated students from Paris who came to Beijing and provided them with documents to disseminate. His biography also states that after he returned to Cambodia during the democratic Kampuchea regime, he was sent by Ankar to be re-educated in a cooperative in Sector 103, where, quote, I was so excited and got my brainwashed and became even more proud of the party. The third biography of a Ministry of Foreign Affairs cadre is that of Uk Sakun, a person whose name has come up a number of times during the historical background segment of this trial. And this is document D366/7.1.831.
point 1.
Point 830.
Point 830.
And his biography describes how he was, quote, converted from being a revisionist, end of quote, partially due to education he received in 1971 from Ing Sari, who is identified by his alias Van. And Uksukun also notes that from 1970 on, he received education from Ing Sari every year. And as a result of the education that he received, he goes on to describe his then current view on revisionism. Quote, I now believe revisionism to be the number one enemy of our socialist revolution and number one enemy of the Communist Party of Kampuchea at present and into the future. As a matter of life and death, we need to continue our struggle against revisionism, especially the Vietnamese revisionists, until they are completely gone. Continuing on at the conclusion of his biography, to state, quote, I have clearly identified the life and death enemies. They are revisionism and the view and standpoint of capitalism and privatism. So these documents are fairly telling evidence that shows, in this case, the role of Ing Sari in political education of cadres, but also in general the process by which cadres who were part of the Communist Party of Kampuchea were educated and trained and made to comply with the party's policies and directives. These biographies also show us, in some cases, who were the groups and classes that were targeted by the CPK as the cadres had to explain their contacts and connections with persons from various groups or classes. And one such targeted group were officials and soldiers from the former regime. And the biographies reflect how cadres had to explain their relationships or contacts with such persons. So, for example, in the biography of the second Ministry of Foreign Affairs cadre, D-366, slash 7.1.829, he identifies the class background of his parents and siblings, including the fact that one of his sisters was married to a soldier who had, quote, ranked chief corporal in the Royal Army and, quote, belonged to a special class serving as a tool of the ruling class. He also goes on in his biography to reveal how, when he was in France in 1969, he went on a camping trip with a group that included A. Long Ken, who was the traitorous Lon Nol's nephew, and also a Frenchman who was, quote, an agent of the French imperialists. So again, these biographies reflect who it was that the CPK considered enemies of the party for whom cadres had to explain their contacts. And in this case, that the particular enemies were people associated with the Lon Nol regime. In fact, the fact that this cadre had had a camping trip in France with Lon Nol's nephew And this is also, I think, a concrete example of the very invasive structure that was implemented by the CPK, in which no detail of a person's current or past life was private, and no stone was left unturned in their search for potential enemies.
Et qu'il fallait examiner cela dans tous les
the
détails
biographies
afin
also
de
contain miscellaneous other facts that are relevant to issues before the chamber in this case,
pour,
including historical background facts and, in some cases, the forced movements. For example, the biography of TCW 724, which, to repeat, is document D366/7.1.831, contains the following statement in its concluding section.
À la fin de ce document, nous pouvons lire les mots
quote,
suivants.
Before returning back to the country in late
avant
1975,
dans le pays,
I did not notice that 17 April 1975 was the end of the People's Democratic Revolution. I did not realize that currency abolition and people evacuation had been practiced in terms of class struggle in order to continue the socialist revolution and to establish a socialist country. Then I realized that they were very important acts that needed to be done after exhausting war. They were just the necessary measures.
Il s'agissait de mesures nécessaires.
The biography of this individual also provides a lot of useful information on the pre-1975 period, as this person was a minister in the GRUNC. Before I move on to the next annex, there were a couple of miscellaneous objections just to briefly respond to relating to these documents. The Ink Sari defense have objected that the biography of TCW 724 should be treated like a witness statement and only admitted if and when that witness testifies. Now, as I've indicated, that witness is on the trial chamber schedule for the next segment. But we strongly disagree with the assertion, the attempt to characterize a biography prepared in 1976 as a witness statement. Witness statements are subject to a different criteria because they are intended, what is covered by that concept is statements that were provided either specifically for litigation proceedings or in anticipation that they could be used as part of some disputed legal proceeding.
Dans le contexte d'une procédure judiciaire.
These biographies are living and breathing contemporaneous documents from the democratic Kampuchea regime that are relevant merely by the fact that they were written.
Dès lors où ils ont été
this is not, these are not submitted as testimony of a witness. As I have explained,
comme je
the very
expliqué,
fact that they had to write these biographies, the fact they had to explain all of these contacts with individuals who are identified as contemptible. No one is asserting that these people actually were contemptible or traitors. It is the mere fact that they had been called upon by the party to explain all the contacts with all these groups of persons that is relevant.
Leur contact avec ces personnes.
So this is, these are far, far from witness statements.
Donc ces documents sont loin d'être des déclarations de témoins.
My colleague has, I think, talked
et
about that issue
que
in
mon
general,
a parlé de cette
but
question de façon
contemporaneous
plus
documents,
les documents
are not witness statements.
Les
they are an important source of evidence. They are a way for evidence to be put before the court in a more economical manner.
présenter
and the reason documents are admitted is because they are considered to have a reliability in terms related to their relevance that allows the court to assess information without having to hear testimony.
De déterminer comment est-ce que les témoignages
the Inksri defense also identified one biography on our list that did not have translations, which was D2/15.36. And I would simply say that of the 41 documents on this annex, there are only a small number left, four, I believe, that do not yet have translations in all three languages.
No requests for those translations are in process. So
we do expect that in the near future, all of the documents on this annex will have complete translations. And obviously, as many people have commented, this is an issue and problem that all parties face. And we certainly have done everything we can and will continue to do so to make sure that the documents that we present are translated in all three languages.
Tous les documents que nous présentons soient disponibles dans les trois langues.
And the last objection, just a quick comment on it. The Kusampan team had objected to some of the biographies on the grounds that a chain of custody had not been established. And again, I think that this is a general issue that has been dealt with before, but I'll simply note that chain of custody is just one way to authenticate documents. With these biographies, you've heard already this morning that there's a wide variety of means by which these are authenticated, both the testimony of some of these individuals who are still alive, testimony of people who were involved in the preparation of these documents, and the form and structure of these documents, where there is a consistent form that allows the trial chamber to look and go
qui a été respecté dans ce document et la Chambre peut donc constater de façon peut constater que ces documents suivent le même format.
The second annex that I will address is Annex 9, which is an annex of S21 prisoner records.
And
just so we are clear, these are different documents than confessions. There were very few objections stated to this annex during the hearings the last few days, so I hopefully can cover this annex relatively quickly. First, just to describe the documents here, this annex consists of lists that were maintained by the same S21 cadre who I mentioned earlier, TCW 698. Who was responsible for identifying prisoners who entered S21 and keeping lists of the prisoners who were there, as well as lists or logs kept of detainees who were being interrogated and lists of detainees who had been executed. So you will see that there is we've endeavored to identify these documents either as a S21 prisoner list, an interrogation log, or an execution log. And there's no question regarding the authenticity of these contemporaneous records that were maintained as part of S21's operations. In his statement to the co-investigating judges, TCW 698 was shown and authenticated a number of examples of these documents. And certainly, if necessary, he could be called to testify and do so here. Though I would also note that next week we will be hearing from the chairman of S21,
entendre,
who certainly also is in position to confirm
that
these were records maintained by S21 to the extent anyone actually disputes that.
S21, au cas où quelqu'un remettrait en compte leur authenticité.
Now, in regards to relevance, as with the S21 biographies that I discussed earlier, the general relevance of the prisoner lists in case 002/01 is again simply to assist in identifying the organizational structure of the Democratic Kampuchea regime and the identity of cadres who held significant positions. Because S21 was used to purge cadres from all DK organizations across the country, one can identify, going through these prisoner lists, the names of K offices that formed 870, the names of districts within particular sectors and zones, the organizational structure of the military, the ministries that were in existence and staffed by cadres, and of course the identity of leading cadres from those organizations who were purged. So the primary use, and as my colleague pointed out yesterday, these lists were submitted at a time when prior to the severance of the case. Nonetheless, there was an effort to identify documents relevant to these first phase issues, and these S21 prisoner lists remain relevant for this contextual background issue of helping to identify what were the various organizations within Democratic Kampuchea and who the individuals were who were from those organizations. But in addition to that general use, some of the S21 prisoner records are also relevant to show that the CPK, in fact, did target former officials and soldiers of the Law Nol regime. This is a critical issue in case 002/01. As the accused are charged with using the evacuation of Phnom Penh as a strategy and means to remove enemies from the base, their cities, and to identify and execute or eliminate those enemies as part of the evacuation. This included executions of Law Nol soldiers and officials who were identified at checkpoints outside Phnom Penh, and the targeting of this group continued, of course, after people had been removed from the cities, placed in cooperatives, and required to submit biographies discussing their background. And the plan to identify and eliminate officials and soldiers of the former regime is reflected in a number of S21 prisoner lists from 1976. The best example of this is an S21 execution log for March 1976, which is case file document IS 7.2. And this document lists 159 former Law Nol soldiers, officials, or relatives who died at S21 that month, March 1976, including 153 who were executed and 6 who died from illness. Within that group, this list includes at least 13 persons who are identified as relatives or family members of Long Bure. Their execution is recorded in numbers 44 to 50, 135 to 136, 149, and entries 153 through 155 of this execution log. The Chamber will recall that Long Bure, of course, was the Prime Minister of the Khmer Republic, and he was one of the seven super traders whose execution was ordered in a statement issued by Khieu Samphan in late February 1975.
Ordonné dans une déclaration this qui a été faite par
document from
S21
shows the ongoing effort to eliminate relatives of Mr. Long
Barret.
And also, the very last entry on this S21 log,
number 159,
records that on the 30th of March
1976,
the four children of Tach Chia were executed. And again, your honors may recall that Tach Chia was a high-ranking official in the Ministry of Education in the prior regime. Long Narin has testified in these proceedings that he was accused of being CIA and directed by Ying Seri to prepare a biography explaining his past relationship with Tach Chia. And you have seen the biography that he prepared, referring to Tach Chia as the contemptible one. Now, while Long Narin survived and was able to testify in these proceedings, the relatives of Tach Chia did not. In addition to the four children whose execution is recorded in IS
7.2,
Deutsch has testified that the wife of Tach Chia was killed in the most horrific of ways through live medical experimentation.
Dans la mesure où elle a fait l'objet d'expériences médicales alors qu'elle était encore vivante.
Other examples of S21 prisoner records that are relevant to establish the CPK policy targeting Lon Nol soldiers and officials
justement noter quelle était la politique de cibler les anciens soldats du régime Lon Nol. Il s'agit D312.1.46,
which is a 22 March 1976 list recording the execution of 47 former soldiers from the previous regime.
47 soldats de l'ancien régime ont été exécutés.
And also D108/26.16. That's D108/26.16, which is a list of six S21 prisoners from 1976, identified as former government officials, including one person who was a palace clerk who is recorded as having been executed. Now, the only specific objection made by the accused to any documents on Annex 9 was the Ying Seri defense's objection to a single document, D108/26.135, which they contend is only relevant to Ying Tirit and hence no longer relevant given her severance. This document is a list of four cadres from the Ministry of Social Affairs who were imprisoned and interrogated or executed at S21. And the issue with this S21 prisoner list is the same as the S21 biographies for Ministry of Social Affairs witnesses. Specifically for purposes of this case, the relevance is limited to demonstrating the administrative structure of the ministries that constituted the Democratic Kampuchea government, including the Ministry of Social Affairs. That is a fairly limited relevance.
Donc leur pertinence
and unless until one gets to the case that includes S21 as part of the crime base, at which time, of course, these documents would have a greater relevance. But at this time, as I indicated, all these documents have a general relevance to show how the regime was structured.
S'agissant de la structure du régime.
Now, I can break at this time.
Si vous le souhaitez, Mr. President, I have three annexes left
to cover,
but
I believe I certainly will take no longer than an hour, possibly as short as half an hour, probably sometime somewhere in between half an hour and an hour to finish the other three annexes.
Il faudra donc entre 30 et 60 minutes pour pouvoir couvrir ces dernières annexes.
The President,
thank you.
Je vous remercie,
International Co-Prosecutor,
Monsieur le Co-procureur international,
for your information about the time that you will need after the lunch break.
S'agissant du temps dont vous aurez besoin cet après-midi, je pense que le moment est venu d'observer une pause
lunch break.
Pour la pause déjeuner.
We will be back at 1:30.
Nous reprendrons à 13h30.
Security guards are instructed to bring
J'invite maintenant les officiers à chercher la sécurité.
Nguyen Chia and Khieu Sompon,
à ramener Khieu Sompon et Nguyen Chia
to the holding cell downstairs.
À la cellule de détention provisoire au sous-sol.
As I note, Mr. Nuzi is on his feet. You may proceed,
Je note
counsel.
Que Maître Yanuzi demande la parole.
Thank you, Your Honor. Very briefly, Nguyen Chia would request to retire to the holding cell this afternoon to follow the proceedings from there.
And
we prepared the relevant documentation, which we will submit to the greffiers.
Suivre la procédure de la cellule de détention provisoire cet après-midi, et nous avons préparé la documentation nécessaire que nous donnerons au greffier. Merci. Le Président, je vous remercie.
Thank you. Having heard Nguyen Chia's request made through his counsel,
nous avons entendu la requête qui a été demandée, qui était présentée par Maître Yanuzi.
Audiovisual means from
et
the holding
cells
downstairs.
À l'unité audiovisuelle de prendre les mesures nécessaires afin de lui permettre de participer au sous-sol.
And that the council will submit to the chamber.
Nous notons
the waiver
que le maître que Maître Yanuzi donnera à la Chambre la documentation nécessaire avec la signature de l'accusé. La Chambre fait droit à cette requête.
The AV unit is also instructed
Nous demandons aussi à l'unité audiovisuelle
live the proceedings to the holding cell
de
this
transmettre
afternoon.
La procédure à la cellule d'intention
Again, security guards are instructed to bring the two
Nous
accused persons to the holding cells downstairs.
Aux gardes de la sécurité
and for
que
the afternoon session,
doivent être ramenés aux cellules d'intention provisoire au sous-sol, et que pour la séance de cet après-midi, ils doivent ramener l'accusé Khieu Sompon au prétoire.
While keeping Mr. Nguyen Chia in the holding cell so that he
restera
can follow the proceedings
from there.
Afin qu'il
puisse suivre la procédure de cet endroit. L'audience est maintenant suspendue.